We are in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning with Chef Carlos DaMoura from the fabulous Fred and Steve's Steakhouse. We're making pork.
Alentejana.
Thank you. Thank you, my friend.
My pleasure.
Okay. Now, let's take a look at some of the ingredients we have to make this great dish. And you know it's a great dish when we have three pans out and everything's getting ready to be going.
That's for sure. Today, we're going to be making pork alentejana, a dish that came from Portugal. We're going to have pork. We have oil, salt and pepper, pickles. We have garlic and also have hot pepper rings and little necks and also potatoes. And not least but last, we also got wine, white wine.
Okay, now is this a traditional Portuguese recipe?
Yes, it is.
We have so many Portuguese people here in the community.
It's a recipe that came from Portugal, and we also feature in our menu at Fred and Steve's. So, and today we're going to be preparing. It's a very, very popular dish, and you're going to enjoy it.
I was going to say, in this state, there are so many Portuguese people. When you make a dish like this, you need to make sure you get it right.
Absolutely. And we get some great review about customers. They visit our restaurants, they impress.
Now, you said this is the pork. How much? About how much are we going to need for this recipe?
For this recipe, we use about 2 pounds of pork.
Okay.
And about a half a pound of potatoes. And about 8 little necks. And that's a recipe.
And any particular potato? I mean, there's so many different variations of potatoes. Anything, can we use red potatoes?
No, you can't.
Or is this your traditional?
You can use any kind of potatoes. They'll be fine. Either your potatoes is fine. Any kind of potatoes is fine for that.
And little necks, I guess that would be a preference of how much you want to put in?
Absolutely. Depends how much you like seafood. If you like a lot of seafood, you put more. If you don't like that much, put less, but it's great.
And how long is this going to take us?
It'll take about 45 minutes from start to the end.
Okay. All right. So we have all our ingredients together. We are going to get set to mix everything together and start cooking things up. In the meantime, back to you.
Thanks, Mary. Chef Carlos DaMoura from Fred and Steve's Steakhouse is joining us to make pork alentejana in the kitchen.
That's right.
I was just telling you, I was going, pork alentejana. How do I know that? My dad loves this dish. He would always come home from the Portuguese restaurant saying, I got pork alentejana again. It's my favorite. All right. So we're going to...
All right.
Marinate the meat now?
Yes, we're going to start with the pork. Usually what I do at the restaurant, we marinate these like a day ahead.
Oh.
That way it's going to give all that flavor, the nice flavor for everything.
Yum.
Start with the wine.
What kind of wine are you using?
I use one of my best wines I have. That's usually what I do because some people, if I can't drink that wine, I'm not going to use it on my marinade. So that's what I do in my cooking.
That's true.
Nothing but the best. With some chopped garlic.
Okay. How much garlic is going in there, roughly?
About 2 tablespoons of garlic.
Okay.
Salt and pepper, got them already mixed.
Nice.
Then you put a little hot sauce.
Oh, love hot sauce. How much is going in there?
About a half a cup of hot sauce.
Okay.
A tablespoons of paprika.
Ooh, getting everything going in there.
Everything going. Then you mix them up.
Okay,
usually what
toss.
I do, mix them up like a day ahead. Even 2 days will be fine because the more time you give to marinade, the better it tastes because it's going to assimilate all that flavor.
Yeah.
And that's what makes a big difference because some people just marinate and try to cook right away. Doesn't work.
And
so
when
give that time.
Can you just keep that in the bowl and what you're putting in the fridge?
Put them in the fridge overnight. Put them in the fridge. Then the next day. And when you're going to do it, you're going to make sure you sear it nice because that way it's going to retain all that moist from that pork.
Okay.
That's a secret. That's a secret right there.
Oh, so there's a certain way to cook it. That way it maintains
enhances all that flavor. That's correct.
Oh, yum. And should you ever, is there a thing as over-marinating?
There's no such thing with
no
the pork.
No such thing.
No such thing with the pork. Like I said, even 2 days, that's what I do at the restaurant. Marinate for 2 days, then when you cook it, it gives a nice, nice flavor. You can taste everything that you put in that marinade.
Excellent. Well, it sounds delicious, and we'll get cooking in just a little bit. Back to you. We are back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning, cooking with Fred and Steve's Steakhouse. Chef Carlos DaMoura joins us to make this fabulous dish. We're going to finish it up now.
Absolutely. The last step. This is what we do. We fry our pork.
And that's the part
you gotta make sure that the oil is nice and hot.
It sounds hot.
It sounds hot. Everybody's bubbling away.
Nice and hot.
That's the pork that we were marinating. You should have been marinated earlier.
That's one to marinate for 2 days.
Okay.
Two days. Just to get a nice, nice flavor.
Okay.
Really
fry it
up.
And get a pan. You're gonna get some little necks going.
A little oil.
Oil in the pan.
Put those on.
Okay. Is this on high heat as well?
Yes, it is.
You want them to crack open, right?
You always hear it when it's
sizzling.
Yeah, that's nice. gives it a little wine.
All right.
Again, the wine that you would drink.
That's correct. You're going to stay away from the sun a little bit.
Woo!
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Whoa. Hey-o. Whoa.
That is so much higher than you.
Yes, this is one of our dish that we're presenting at the restaurant, which you have set. We also have another menu that we start the next month. Month of April. Popping over here.
That fire, the fire always gets us.
Yes, it's what these are. The wine, alcohol, and the
bun. I got to turn the fan on. Let's see here. Let's clear some of that out.
Yes, so next month we're going to start presenting a new menu. It's at $22. You get an appetizer. And you get two meals for $22.
Appetizer, okay. And two meals? Yes.
An appetizer, two meals, and a dessert. So now we know the economy is a little bad,
right? Yeah.
But we take the hit. Not our customers. That's how we roll as Fred and Steve.
That is a great deal.
That's a good deal.
And, two for $22.
We also have a three for $33, which is an appetizer.
Oh, my gosh.
You get an entree. You get a dessert. So we have menus that can suitable for everybody's budget.
I love
everybody.
That.
You go in. You sit. Okay, so you cook.
Right, so we got this.
So this is cooking up. About how long is this cooked up for?
This we're gonna sear it for about 5 minutes.
Okay.
After 5 minutes, just sear both sides. Make sure that
everything's
nice,
cooked through.
Everything's cooked through.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Then you can add your clams. You can mix your clams.
Okay.
A lot of people get worried when they cook pork to make sure that it's cooked. Just, you know, you always hear the things about, how do I know when it's cooked right? How long should I cook it? You know, what are we looking for?
Yeah, in this situation, you're gonna look for the tenderness.
Okay.
When you use the fork and you go all the way through, that means it's done. So you're gonna know. Now to make the sauce, you're gonna add some more wine.
Mm-hmm.
When you're saying wine. More, I mean, how much sauce is actually in there? About how much?
Just a layer. You're gonna use about a cup of wine.
About a cup, okay.
Then you're gonna.
What's a little more than a cup to me, Carlos? Depends.
Some people like a little bit. Some people like a lot of wine.
That's all right.
So you're gonna let it simmer.
In there now.
This is a clam stock.
Okay.
No, just clam stock. Okay.
Yes, about 2 cups of clam stock.
Just to make like a broth almost?
Yes. Yeah. Just a broth.
So mm-hmm.
Then you let it simmer. It's gonna take about.
It does
smell. Thank you. It's gonna take about 20 minutes to cook it through, way through.
And are we keeping it on high, or are we turning the heat
now,
down?
Now you're
simmer?
Gonna put a medium flame.
Medium flame, okay.
Medium flame.
So the fan can go off.
That's right.
Now, no more flames.
No more flames. Now we're safe. All right. Then you're also gonna go with potatoes. Potatoes, some people prefer to do a bake, some people prefer deep fry.
Right.
And deep fry, I prefer to do deep fry. But if you're in a special diet, you can do a bake, it works equally.
I love
so
that.
that's
And you're gonna throw those in there with it?
Yes, the potatoes gonna go with that. Now you're gonna add some cornstarch.
Alright, what's that going to do?
Cornstarch, okay.
That's what's going to make the gravy. That's what's going to make the
gravy. Thicken it up a little bit.
That's a good stuff.
It's a secret weapon.
And about how much of this are we going to use for this? Or you just got to basically test it out and see how you...
You got to test it out.
Alright.
But it's about a half a cup.
Okay.
Then you're going to let it simmer.
Alright. And we'll quickly throw everything else in there.
Put everything together.
We have finished one.
Exactly. Now I got a finished product.
Put that over.
That. Presented right here.
There we go.
Grab some forks quick.
Absolutely, you can try it.
We'll
for the
give
taste.
It a try.
See how you
so
like
we got
it.
The 2 for $22, the 3 for $33. It is all at Fred and Steve's Steakhouse. Be sure to check it out. And
if you want this recipe, you can head to our website at WPRI.com.
Enjoy it.
Mm.